Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing fine and are taking care of yourselves. My name is Kanika Tandon and I am here with the video of class 4th English grammar. In our last video we have completed till chapter number 17 and today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 18, agreement of the verb with the subject. And with the completion of this chapter, your syllabus of unit test will also be over. Starting our today's video with chapter number 18, that is agreement of the verb with the subject. With the name of the chapter, it is easy for us to understand that this chapter is all about the rules that we have to use while we are writing the verb in the sentence according to the subject. In this, if we start reading the chapter, first is the boy writes a letter, the boys write letters. In the first sentence, the subject boy is the singular number, therefore the verb writes is also the also singular, and in second sentence the subject boys is plural, that is why the verb is also plural. So there is one thing that we have to keep in mind is whenever the subject in the sentence is singular, the verb is also singular, and whenever the subject is in plural, the verb is also plural. Right, like with the subject boy, since there is only one boy that we're talking about, we use writes. Writes is in singular form, and whenever and boys with the word boys, which is plural, we always use write, which is plural. Thus, it is clear from these sentences that a verb takes the same number as its subject. Next is I go to the market, he goes to the market. In both of these sentences, the subjects are in the singular number. But in first sentence, the subject I belongs to the first person, and the second sentence, the subject belongs to the third person. That is why in one sentence we are using singular subject, and in second sentence we are using plural subject. Next is some special application of the rule. So first is two or more singular subjects connected by and takes a plural verb. For example, Mahesh and Dinesh are friends because the talking about them is almost same, but these are two different people. So it is plural. Mahesh and Dinesh. Next is Mumbai and Kolkata are metropolitan cities. Mumbai and Kolkata, though we are talking same about them, but are two different cities. So because of that, here in one and is oh sorry R is used. Coming on to the next page, two or more singular subjects connected by and takes a singular subject if they refer to the same person or the thing, like the dramatist and poet has passed away. If the article is used before the first noun or adjective only, it is considered referring to the same person. If articles are used separately before each noun or adjective, they are considered as separate person. Similarly, the dramatists and the poet have passed away. Next is two or more singular subjects connected by and takes a singular subject if they express one idea or thought. Bread and butter is my breakfast. Here, bread and butter act as only one, and they are expressing only one thought. So it is denoted by is, which is a singular verb. Next is two singular subjects connected by and takes a singular verb if they are preceded by each or every. Like every man and every woman was present there. So there are two singular subjects. Every man is one singular subject and every woman is another singular subject. So it is connected by singular verb. Next is two or more singular subjects connected by either or, neither nor, takes a singular verb. Neither tea nor coffee was available there. When two subjects connected by either or, neither nor, belong to different person, the verb agrees with the nearer subject. Like either she or I am misunderstood, either you or she is misunderstood. Here, if the subjects are connected with either or neither, either or neither nor, then the subject will always be, sorry, the verb will always act as a singular verb, that and it will be related to the nearer subject. इट विल एक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू द नियरर सब्जेक्ट. नेक्स्ट इज व्हेन अ सिंगुलर नाउन इज कनेक्टेड टू अ सेकेंड नाउन बाय विद और एज वेल एज द वर्ब मस्ट बी सिंगुलर. सो व्हेनेवर वी आर यूजिंग विद और एज वेल एज द वर्ब विल ऑलवेज बी सिंगुलर. लाइक रमेश विद हिज फ्रेंड्स वॉज वॉचिंग television. So Ramesh is one subject and his friends are another subject. So but they are connected with. So the verb will also be singular. Next is a noun which is in plural in form but singular in meaning takes a singular verb. The news is not true. So the noun which is plural in form like news is always plural but the verb will be taken as singular only. Next is a collective noun takes a singular verb when the collection is thought of as a whole. It takes a plural verb when the individuals of the collections are thought of separately. Now this is very important. Whenever we are using a collective noun like a bouquet, committee, army, team, these are what? Collective nouns, right? So whenever we are using these words, we always, whenever we are using it as collective noun like the committee was united on that point. So the committee is about that committee, we're talking it as a whole. So the verb will always be singular. And the committee were divided in their decision. So committee is in singular form. So here the verb is plural. With this, the explanation of the chapter is over. Let us come on to the exercise. Coming on to exercise on page number 87, first one is underline the correct verb in the bracket in the following sentences. So what we have to do, we have to read the options given in the bracket and then write the answers according to the subject. So 11 players make a cricket team. Rekha and Radha are neighbors. The writer and journalist were present in the conference. Neither you nor I am at a fault. Every man and every woman has gone to the fair. Neither air nor water was pure there. Either Neha or Archana is guilty. Neither you nor he is right. The news was incorrect. The jury were divided in their opinion. Coming on to the next one. Fill in the blanks with the appropriate forms of verbs in bracket. So in this, what we have to do, we have to read the bracket. What does he say? And then write the verb accordingly. First is either he or I am going to Delhi next week. The father as well as the son is here. The committee has issued its report. Every boy and every girl has passed an examination. Neither the doctor nor the nurse is in the hospital. The plane with its crew was lost. Physics is my favorite subject. Gulliver's Travels was written by Swift. The principal and secretary are coming for inspection. The actor and the singer have passed away. Ramesh or Mohan is absent today. Riya and Priya have come to meet me in the hospital. With this, the exercise of this chapter is over and also the unit test syllabus is over. I'll see you all in my next video with the next chapter. Till then, keep studying and do complete your work till chapter number 18 or page number 87. Thank you.